Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Shapes are a great way to make your presentations more interesting. PowerPoint gives you a lot of different shapes to choose from, and they can be customized to suit your needs, using your own color palette, preferences, and more. To get started, go to the Insert tab, click the Shapes command, then take a look at the menu and see if there is anything you want to use. In this example, we're going to select the heart shape here. To draw your shape, click and drag the mouse roughly where you want it to go. The shape will appear with your current color scheme. The quickest way to change the look of your shape is to use one of the predefined shape styles on the Format tab. These options will depend on the colors that are part of your current theme. Just hover over each one for a preview and see if there's anything you like. You can also use the commands on the right to choose your own formatting options, such as the fill color, outline color, and other shape effects. You can even change the shape itself if you want to try something different. Make sure that the shape you want to change is selected. Then click the Edit Shape command on the far left of the Format tab. You can then choose a new shape from the menu. I'm going to go with the sun shape. And I think I'd like to make a few more tweaks. First, I'm going to make the shape a little smaller using the sizing handles here. These can be found on the sides and the corners of any shape or object in PowerPoint. Every shape also has a rotation handle that you can drag in any direction to rotate it. If your shape has any yellow handles, like the one you see here, you can use those to make other adjustments. In this case, the yellow handle changes the proportions of the sun, but it really just depends. Some shapes don't have this option at all. Finally, I think I'll change the fill color to something that's a little more appropriate for a sun. How about this yellow color? The great thing about shapes is that they can be combined and customized to create your own unique graphics. Mastering this element can take time, but with a little practice and a little creativity, you can create almost anything. Let's try adding another shape so I can show you what I mean. And I'll just tweak the fill color and remove the outline. And there we go. When you're working with multiple shapes, there may be a time when you want to change the order so the correct shape is in front or on top. This will come up a lot with shapes, so it's a good technique to know. Just right-click one of your shapes, then go to Bring to Front and Send to Back. Now you may need to experiment with these options to make sure your shapes are arranged the way you want. In this example, I've selected the cloud shape, and I want to move it behind the sun. So I'm going to choose Send to Back, then Send Backward. And that'll do it. There are so many things you can do with shapes in PowerPoint. This graphic is just one example. So give it a try and see what you can come up with. You can use just one shape at a time, or you can try combining them to create something new.